My name is Janet Ady, and I'm the Chief of the Division of Education, Interpretation, and Partnerships in the National Conservation Lands and Community Partnerships Directorate of the Bureau of Land Management in Washington, D.C.
And I'm Drew Burnett, and I'm a Branch Chief in the Division of Education and Outreach of the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's National Conservation Training Center.
We were faced with a situation in Alaska, Western Alaska, but we had species of geese that were declining seriously. So money came from Congress to help address the issue, and law enforcement wasn't an option. We couldn't, I mean, there's no habitat restoration or creation, you know, that wasn't the issue. But the issue really was people and their behavior and their willingness to take a positive action, you know, to help the situation. So that was an opportunity for environmental education to really solve a resource management problem and really be in that mix. And so for me, that was a time where environmental education went, you know, for me and my work with the Fish and Wildlife Service from being something that you do because you need environmental literacy and you need aware citizens, and you want youth to be exposed at all levels of their education, you know, to all of these ecological principles and concepts. It went from more of that knowledge, awareness, and understanding to a real problem-solving action resource management tool.
Every federal agency, depending on what its mission is going to look at environmental education in a slightly different way. For example, EPA, which has primarily a regulatory role, is very interested in building environmental literacy among the citizenry because they recognize that regulations are not the most efficient and effective way to address the primary environmental issues they're confronting right now, which is non-point source pollution. So they're very much interested in using what they call voluntary programs, which are really environmental education programs, to address that problem. They're trying to influence individual behaviors. From a land management perspective, it's a little bit different because I think there are various ways that land management agencies can engage in environmental education to not only have a direct conservation outcome on the land, by involving either young people or citizens in the actual stewardship of the land, the projects that we have to do to manage our refuges and parks and forests. But I think also they are interested in environmental education as a way to build community support, just overall. If you have solid community relations with the communities that surround the chunk of land that you're trying to manage, it's going to be you're going to be far more effective at managing that land if you have that kind of support of your neighboring landowners, yeah, and communities. So I think that those are three different ways I think that federal agencies use environmental ed to achieve their missions. And I think the one that's probably the most difficult and that we're really focused in on the field right now is to do a better job of showing how environmental education actually does result in conservation outcomes.
Right.
So that we can then show our land managers that in addition to whatever other practices they're using to achieve their conservation outcomes, environmental ed should be a tool in their toolbox just like all the others.
Right. So. Right. A tool in the mix and one that you would use to differing degrees depending on what it is you're trying to do. In the Alaska example, that was all you could do. But in other examples, there might be a little bit of education that would help.
We can't achieve our mission unless we do this through partnerships. I mean, because we don't just train our own staff. Well, our staff come with their partners to
right.
Almost all of our training programs train partners as well.
Yeah.
And then we partner with other organizations like NAAA
right.
and Project Learning Tree and so forth, mm-hmm. to Project Wild to offer professional development to our staff and their partners. So,
exactly. And another huge area of partnership is the other federal agencies. And The Environmental Protection Agency has been a huge partner and brought funds in, not for federal employees, but for the partners really to work together. So it's kind of a interconnected network really. And nobody is able to do it all on their own, that's right. For sure. And that's the beauty of the field of environmental education. It's very collaborative. People are always willing to come together to see, okay, what do we need to do to work together? Who's bringing what strengths? You know, where's our niche? How do we fit in to kind of move everything forward and float all boats, if you will? And that's one of the fun things about being in the field, yeah. I think.